part of the service design. So you can measure it, you can quantify it, you can improve it. So having said that, you have a strategy, you understand the market, the customers, we assume so. We design a beautiful service around it, we overcome the challenges and risks, we have the metrics in place. Now the service has to be transitioned in terms of, okay, before we hit the ground on an operational day to day, how do we transition the service? So the purpose of service transition is to ensure that, like say, the new, the modified or any retired service meet the expectations of the business as documented in the service strategy and service design stages. The main objectives here is to plan and manage the service changes efficiently and effectively. Change management, one of the very important areas of business. So service transition focuses on this service changes. So it needs to be done effectively and efficiently. So we need to manage risks relating to providing a new service or a service which is changed or a service which is retired. We need to successfully deploy service releases into supported environments. That is what is we call it as the service operations. We need to set correct expectations on the performance part of the service in terms of what is the performance of the new service or the service which has gone through a change. And we need to ensure that the service changes basically create the expected or the perceived business value, what comes out of service strategy. And we need to provide good quality knowledge and information about the services and service assets. So service transition is again a critical aspect to the entire life cycle of service management end to end. Say for example, some of the transition policies, we need to define and implement a formal policy for service transition, implement all changes to the services through a service transition, no ad hoc changes, adopt a common framework and standards. So there is a concept of institutionalization across the organization. People speak the common vocabulary. We need about maximizing the reuse of established processes and systems, some of the lessons learned from the previous services, service offerings and experiences of our customers need to be captured. We need to align service transition plans with, of course, the business needs, which is paramount importance. We need to establish, maintain relationships with the stakeholders, which is very crucial. To establish effective controls and disciplines, we need to provide systems for knowledge transfer and certain decision support systems. Manage any course corrections, mid-course corrections before the service is operational. We need to proactively manage across the entire aspect of transition. Ensure that there is an early involvement in the service life cycle and proactively improve quality the entire service transition. So for example, these are some of the transition policies. There are 7 critical processes with respect to service transition in terms of transition planning and support. Change management, in itself is a huge process area. It's an entire business in terms of change management. Service asset and a repository for managing these assets. The release and deployment management. Service validation and testing. Evaluating a change to a service. Of course, building the huge knowledge base. This is, again, very important. Like any other ITIL framework volumes, service transition has its own set of challenges, the risks, and of course we can overcome them. The key challenge here is every business process and service in IT resulting in a large customer and stakeholder group that is involved and impacted by service transition. This is a key challenge. Managing many contacts, interfaces, relationships, so service transition is again a challenge. A little harmonization and integration of the processes and disciplines that kind of impact service transition. Say for example, the finance, the HR. And we need to establish leaders to champion the changes and improvements. This is a key challenge. And we need to establish who's doing what, when and where, and who should be doing what, when and where. This is often our entire time is spent on understanding who's doing what, when, where, and who should be doing what, when, and where. The risks is in change in accountabilities, responsibilities, say for example, unplanned cost to services in transition and resistance to change and kind of perceived bureaucracy. This is something very difficult to handle as well. Of course, there is a way we can overcome that. It's by understanding and managing different stakeholder perspectives, which basically like kind of underpins the effective risk management within an organization and establishing and maintaining this stakeholder buy-in and commitment. This is a very easy statement to make, but it's very difficult to actually implement and have a control over it. We need to have a clearly defined relationships and interfaces with the program and the projects what we manage. So this is what service transition is all about. We slightly move on to the service operation.